formerly prosperous Eastern Han Dynasty had become a crumbling empire, plagued by continuous conflict among warlords. In 215 AD, Sun Quan, leader of the Kingdom of Wu, attacked Hefei. Hefei was an important city in the territory of Cao Cao, leader of the Kingdom of Wei. Instead of organizing a defense and waiting for assistance, General Zheng Liao led a small group of just 800 warriors to attack Sun Quan's forces before they could set up camp. Zheng Liao, wearing armor and holding a halberd, raced towards Sun Quan, who decided to run for his life. This incident was described in the records of the Three Kingdoms. This encounter made Zheng Liao's iron halberd and his bravery famous. A halberd is a unique and highly effective ancient Chinese weapon. For more than eight centuries, it was standard issue for Chinese armies. Zhou Zhengwu, ancient weapons expert, is recreating this weapon. A halberd is a combination of lance and dagger axe. It was originally made of expensive bronze. In the Han Dynasty, newly developed steel took the place of bronze. This type of carbon steel went through many stages of tempering to remove impurities from the iron. To ensure it was strong enough, the head and body of the halberd were usually made of a single piece of steel. To demonstrate its power, we've invited martial artist Cheng Yugeng to carry out a test. Cheng Yugeng is an expert with a spear. Now he's going to show how powerful the legendary halberd can be. The halberd was created when chariots were used in battle. The warriors in the chariots were traditionally armed with lances and dagger axes. The halberd was created to take advantage of the strength of both a lance and a dagger axe. With a halberd, a soldier only needed to carry one weapon, one that combined the functions of a lance and a dagger axe. Its power was often noted in historical texts. We will now demonstrate how powerful these techniques are. Since both the halberd and the spear are good at stabbing, we're going to do a comparison test using a pig carcass with leather armor to represent a human. We want to see if the Halberd can penetrate the armor.
还是挺强的，但是跟我们平时练的枪来比，这个杀伤力还相对来说要小一点，因为它有一个小支在阻挡的这个戟的前进性进攻性。如果要是枪的话，肯定贯穿的能力更强一点。这戟的刺的这威力还是非常强大的，没看怎么费力，就穿过了皮甲。 从这边都穿透体腔了，是吧？看一下这皮甲也没起什么大的作用，要是在战场上，肯定是致命了。The
design of the halberd limits its effectiveness for directly piercing an enemy's body. A different technique is to peck the enemy with the halberd's branched blade, much like a woodpecker pecking a tree. This is a powerful and effective technique.
这个动作需要这个腰胯的扭转发力，加上上肢的配合，做到有效的、准确的击打这个目标。但是从这个实验的效果看出来，这个击打的力度是非常大的。和刺差不多，也是看着没费什么大的力量，也是就直打这个枝的根部。这次呢？ 是给这个脊柱的椎体，整个从这个胸椎的椎体给打穿了过来，力量也是非常大的。The
halberd is certainly a lethal weapon, but so far we haven't seen much advantage over a lance or a dagger axe. We may not have found the right technique to maximize its power. Warriors using halberds and dagger axes were often called hook soldiers. Perhaps the major function of these two weapons was to hook the enemy instead of piercing or pecking them. According to the Book of Sun Tzu, someone hooked on the neck by a halberd would lose all their fingers.
家呼手是什么意思？就是往头上招呼。 那么招呼下来之后呢，人的潜在反应就是会去做防御。那么这个时候，你肯定会用手指会去挡，或者说去护住其他的一些这个固定的部位。那么这个时候呢，挤这个强大的攻击力呢，就会把你的有可能会把你的手指全部切掉。It
turns out that all other techniques could be turned into a hooking technique, especially when the initial strike is ineffective. When the warrior pulls his halberd back, it naturally becomes a hook.
我认为这个钩击跟这个以前的这个刺击跟斫击相比，它这个伤害力会小一点，因为它这个从这个身体的运动形式和距离来看，它比它们要短，所以它的杀伤力会小。
When he strikes the target with a hooking technique, it makes a cut about 8 centimeters deep.
这要是人的，来说颈部给这软组织要割了，任何一侧的大血管割断了，那都保不住命了，都属于致命伤。
刚才我们说这个挤的这个测试这个勾的动作呢。 我觉得是能够完全的符合历史上所谓这个十指锯断的这个效果，也就是说它的攻击力呢能够达到让这个手指被切断，能够在颈部造成致命伤，也能够在这个手臂或者手腕上造成这种深可见骨的这种让你能够迅速丧失战斗力的这种伤害。
In the Eastern Zhou Dynasty, the halberd was the go-to weapon for the army because of its effectiveness in battle. Our tests have shown that the halberd was a very versatile weapon, combining the functions of both spear and dagger axe. Its many strengths helped it become the most popular weapon of the era.As use of the halberd became more common, soldiers became known as halberd carriers. During the Warring States period, a famous war strategist even described the army of the Kingdom of Chu as a million halberd carriers. A strange stone carving was discovered in Jiangsu province that has mystified the experts.It clearly depicts a warrior with a halberd next to a man naked from the waist up. His armor and strange hook and shield weapon lay on the ground. A shield is a weapon that combines a long hook and a small shield mounted on the shaft. Like weapons made in the Han Dynasty, it was made of strong steel. It's hard to see how such a strange weapon could be effective in actual battle.It looks more like something used in some religious rite, but it makes more sense as a weapon that was somehow effective in battle.
看着很好用，但是呢，
太沉了。
哎呦，很有力啊，这个
啊，
很重，
还可以
再勾、啄、刺。
We tried several techniques, based on the way it's held and the sharpest part of the blade, but the results were far from ideal.
通过这个使用这种武器啊，反复试验，感觉着呢，就是它这个武器啊，更多是用于防守。如果我们进攻，可能十次，有八次也进攻不到对手。
The ancient Chinese military book, Wei Liaozi, notes that an arrow can kill someone from 100 paces or more, but a lance or halberd requires a distance of less than 50 paces. This means that an army would be attacked first by arrows. We set up two rubber dummy targets.One with a regular shield, and the other with a hook and shield weapon. We fired 6 arrows at each to see how effective they were against arrows. regular shield successfully blocked all six arrows, but the hook and shield blocked only one, allowing the five other arrows to hit the rubber dummy.
钩箱呢，它的这个防御面积只有这个盾牌大概九分之一不到。那么我们看到，它这五支箭全部都打到身体上，而且这个打的这个位置，像琵琶骨之类的，如果是在这个盾牌的情况下，它都是能防住的。但是因为钩箱这个中间这个箱的防御面积太小，所以它实际上完全做不到。
And Chengzhe Jian are now going to simulate a fight between one person armed with a hook and shield and one with a lance.
对这两种武器呢，我也是头一次接触。这个呢，咱们试验一下，看看究竟谁的厉害。 这钩箱对长矛占不着什么优势，那个钩箱啊，在钩那个长矛的时候很难起到作用。钩箱钩到长矛的时候，长矛依然可以撤回去，对我进攻。
The two rounds of tests have shown that this strange weapon is not particularly effective against arrows or lances, but it seems possible that it was designed to counter the halberd. 钩箱 carving from the turbulent Han dynasty seems to indicate that some soldiers with halberds encountered opponents they had never seen before.
钩箱、hook、and shield weapons as they awaited the attack of the Han soldiers, but were they really effective against soldiers armed with halberds? Images
from the Han dynasty seem to indicate that the hook and shield seems to be closely related to the use of the halberd. They also give some idea of how the weapon was wielded. 钩箱 Wudang and Chengzhe Jian theorize that its fundamental purpose in battle was to hook the halberd, specifically its branched blade. On the other hand, if the hook failed to engage the halberd, the soldier wielding it would be in immediate danger from the halberd's powerful blade. The next step is to see how effective it is in countering the hooking and pecking techniques of the halberd.
我们演练一下，试一试，好吗？好的。A
soldier would try to hook the halberd with a weapon in his left hand, then pull back to get it away from his opponent. After which, he would attack his opponent with the sword in his right hand.
他的铁戟被我勾住的时候，他蹬回去的可能很小，因为我会迅速进攻的。
The combination of a hook and shield weapon with a sword can be effective against the halberd, but would require an impractically high level of skill.
This 样的动作在武术的是经常用的，因为他勾住对方以后猛转身，踏步转身，这在武术里边是进攻的速度加快了。
With equally matched opponents, the hook and shield is effective in blocking a halberd and opening up an opportunity for a fatal strike. The tests show that this strange weapon was designed to counter the halberd.
他在弓箭和其他兵器的这个面前，他实际上没有什么防御能力，所以他并不是说第一线的这种大规模配备的肉搏兵器，他实际上是一种待到这个铁戟出现之后，他才会上去进行完压制之后迅速撤回来的这么这样一种兵器。
We can imagine the shock of a group of halberd carriers 2,000 years ago as they were about to attack opponents wielding hook and shield weapons. The enemy would quickly disarm and kill the halberd carriers. In a sense, the hook and shield knocked the halberd off its pedestal.
在使用的时候，包括训练，包括装备，都不是很简单的一件事情。它很重，那么你需要大量的训练才能够灵活地控制它。而且你在制造的时候，它的成本会比环首刀啊，还有其他的，尤其是盾，可能成本要高很多倍。所以这个武器呢，注定是难以大规模去推广的。
When the halberd became the most popular battle weapon, the hook and shield weapon was created to counter it.But the halberd was fairly ineffective against the stronger armor that emerged in the northern and southern dynasties. Along with the hook and shield, it gradually fell out of favor, to be replaced by the cavalry lance. But the memory of the competition between the halberd and the hook and shield weapon is preserved in those ancient images.Times of war give rise to better and more effective weaponry. Two examples are the so-called bright light armor and the heavier and more powerful lance for mounted soldiers. Join us for part 7 of Weapons of Ancient China.